Good morning. We are in our third day where we're looking at the parables of Jesus in Matthew 13. And I'm just going to jump right into the next parable. I'm in Matthew 13, verse 31. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed, which a man took and planted in his field. Though it is the smallest of all your seeds, yet when it grows, it is the largest of the garden plants and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and perch in its branches. That's the short parable. Well, what is he talking about? He said, the kingdom of heaven is like a man that takes a mustard seed, the smallest of seeds, plants it in his field, but then it grows gargantuan. It becomes like a tree, and the birds of the air come and perch in it. Rest in it. Let me get the right word. Jesus is saying to his followers then that his movement was going to start very, very small. He was going to be rejected by the religious leaders. They were ultimately going to crucify him. It looked like it was going to be a movement that died before it got started. At the day that he's crucified, we only know that he had 11 followers. We find that, you know, days later, 50 days later at Pentecost, there's 120 that are his followers, but it was a small movement. It was such an unlikely movement to succeed. Here's this itinerant Jewish carpenter, and he has a handful of followers. Some are illiterate, some not. And it starts without the popular support, even of the mass of Jews, and particularly the Jewish leaders. It's squelched or pounced upon by the Roman Empire. And yet, just like Jesus predicted, it starts out small, like a small seed. But then within 300 years, it had all but conquered the Roman Empire. 326, I believe, is the exact date when Constantine, the Roman emperor, had to declare the Roman Empire to be Christian, because so many people had become followers of Christ in his empire that the only way he could retain his political status was to declare Christianity the official empire of the religion. So just like Jesus predicted, what an unlikely prediction. He stands there and declares it, but time has proven it to be so. Now this gives us a few things to to think about. First of all, God is not at all concerned about small beginnings. He understands that laying foundations take a disproportionate amount of time, but once foundations are laid sufficiently, then you have something to build on, and building can then take place on a disproportionate level. So sometimes in our own lives, we get into those places where, you know, it seems like we're making a lot of effort, but very little is coming forth. Remember this parable of the mustard seed. It starts out so small, but give it time, and watch what God will do. Your